Okay, so you can see here that we put the stickers on as they requested on the rear and on the bottom. Just turn it around when you're ready. The bottom one there, that's obviously to stop people opening it up or just to warn people. So you can put stickers at the front, but I find that these stickers will just, I think they'll just look a bit tacky and peel off. So I'm going to leave it blank. Obviously this is your power, which you'll see the LED will come on and off. Your headphone socket, 1/4 inch, volume, and then your input. So that'll be 1, and that'll be 2. So I'm quite happy with that. And then you can't really go wrong with the valves, the ones that you've received. There's only 2 types, which are these chappies, ECC82, which will go in the V9As. Let's chuck those in. So yeah, the valves do come with the kit on this, but you can use the other types of valve. Like that. And then push this through. These are all JJs. Good solid tube. Quite musical JJs, I find. Slight rotation while you're pushing it down. See, there is, you've got the locator key thing there. Make sure that's they are good joining our bases. So right, so she's kind of ready for switching. I'm just gonna have a read, see. There you go, look, it says complete. And then it's got a list of cautions before you switch on. Make sure the amplifier is placed at least 10 centimetres away from walls. We know what we're doing. Operation check. So it tells you the sequence of events for operation check. With valve amps, when you turn them on, you kind of need to have a load. You can't just turn them on without any speakers connected or resistors. So we've got quite a few drive units lying around the place, so I'm going to use a couple of drive units. Just attach them with crocodile clips, hopefully I've got some of those. So be back in a few minutes with the drivers that we're going to use. So we're going to turn her on. Got a couple of old drivers. Don't be surprised when she starts playing, it will sound a bit naff because they're just drivers sat on the side. Just wired them up with crocodile clips and wires. Source is off Elliot's laptop. So just 3.5 jack going into the input here. This is input 1. IC leads plugged in. So at the front, this is the on-off switch, so that will glow. So just turn it on, like that. I mean, you can't see in this light, but you might want to dim the lights. And then, I can see the glow of the ECC82s. And then, yeah, you can see from the side the 6L6s, GC. So there's tunes going in, music going in. It's on input 1. There you go. Yeah, so it's not impressive, the sound, but you can see it's working. There is a list of how you go about it. We just went in and just turned it on. But that's the way we rock here. So operation checks, turn off the power. LED coming on, make sure the valves are glowing, wait for 30 seconds and put a signal through, turn the sound volume. One thing we haven't done is connect a set of headphones. Turn the sound volume down. But have we got a set of, we've got headphones with quarter inch jack? I don't think I've got an adapter. We haven't, have we? Okay, well, we like to listen to music through speakers anyway, don't we? So, but we will get around to getting some headphones on. When all okay. That's it, brilliant. So maybe we should get the big old cubes out, put those on, see how they sound. What do you think?